Welcome to Walkers on the Wild Side. I'm Scott Walker, and in this video, we're going to go out and capture some autumn colours. Now, this wasn't a video I planned to make. I was driving up to the Peak District this morning, and we've had incredibly changeable weather. And when I got up here, the colours are absolutely beautiful. Not necessarily of the trees. Many of the trees still seem to be hanging on to the green, but the moors look wonderful. Behind me, you can see that all the moor grasses have turned a really orangey golden colour, and the heather has gone a very dark reddish brown. So I'm looking forward to doing something a bit more off the cuff than usual, and we'll give you some tips along the way to capture the best of those autumn colours. So I'm going to take three shots and do an exposure blend. Now, one of those will be for the sky to bring out some of that moodiness that I'm currently seeing. I've got another one for the moors in the distance where we're getting some of that dark patches of heather that's turned. It used to be purple and now it's kind of dark browny red. And another one that's correctly exposed for these beautiful golden grasses. So all of them I'm taking at quite fast shutter speeds. I'm on 1/800th at the minute because it's quite windy. And I'm also going to use a 2-second self timer. So what that does is it allows you to press the button, you wait 2 seconds, and then it takes the exposure. And that's to make sure that any vibrations that you've introduced by pressing the shutter are gone by the time it actually captures the picture. So let's go and do the first one of those shots. Let's frame it up. So I'm looking at, that's the one for the sky. Number one, I will raise the ISO slightly without moving the camera for the background. Number two, and now I'm going to bring the exposure to the proper level to get this beautiful golden grass in. And here it is. This image perfectly reflects my experience from today. Moody yet rich in golden colour. And to produce this photo, it was important to blend the exposures. Camera sensors don't have the same dynamic range as our eyes do, so exposure blending is a great way to get something similar to what you can see with your eyes. In the video footage where I was filming myself, I was exposing for me and the foreground, and the sky is bright, you can't see the detail. But in the footage of the moors, I exposed for the sky, and you can see that the moors were dark. Using a graduated filter could produce a similar result, but it's often much easier just to blend your exposures. Man, that got very unpleasant very quickly as that low cloud came in, rain clouds followed it. But I'm just starting to see some light coming through on those hills over there. So I'm waiting around for the opportunity of another shot. For images like this, where there's high contrast between the highlights and the shadows, I find it's often best to expose for the highlights and let the shadows fall away into darkness. Doing this whilst finding a gap in the clouds allowed me to capture those autumn colours of the dying heather across the landscape, whilst also showing off that dark and moody sky. Wow, look how things have changed. In just the course of about 10 or 15 minutes, I've gone from getting absolutely rained on to having some glorious sun, and I've just been taking some shots of Higgator behind me with the clouds casting shadows moving across it, and that is where I'm going to go to next. Now look at these beautiful golden ferns. So I've set up a composition here where I've got this path, which makes an S, round to a beautiful silver birch tree just there. And I'm using my circular polarising filter because I want to cut off some of the shine that's on these ferns from all the rain that we've had. And I'm just waiting now for a little bit of mixed cloud to come in the background, so it's not too blue, it's not too white. So I'm really looking forward to this one. Using the circular polarising filter allowed me to cut out the shine from those wet ferns and to emphasise their orange colour. Whilst using an aperture of f11 also allowed me to capture all the detail in the scene, from the foreground heathers to the midground rocks and the beautiful silver birch in the background. So I've reached the part of the moor that looks onto Higgator, the hill that I was photographing earlier from the other side with the light moving across it. And we've got all of this dying heather. And a few weeks ago, this would have been purple, but now it's changed to a sort of reddish colour with white tips. And it would be great to be able to light that up. Now, the light at the minute is absolutely rubbish. So I'm just waiting for something to light up this land here. Maybe get some light on the hills in the background. I need some of these clouds to clear, and in the meantime, I'm going to find a composition for that. But what I've also got here are some massive boulders, which I'm going to try to get some shots of. Now, they're huge, and it's very difficult in this video for you to understand the scale of them. But I went up and stood next to those earlier, and say I'm just under 6 feet tall, I reckon that the biggest one of those was nearly four times my height. So you're talking sort of 38-ish, no, what's four times six? Six, 12, 24 feet high. So that's quite a big boulder. And I'm going to try and get some shots as well, looking out to the hills in the background, because we are getting some interesting light there. I really like this last shot. It's effectively four scenes in one image. The foreground gritstone rocks are typical of the Peak District, moving through the image to the edges of the moor with their autumnal ferns and heather, and into some farmland which is just turning golden, and that's lit up by a gap in the clouds, and then onwards through to the background where you can see rains heavily falling over the hills. The duality of this bright sunlight and heavy rain shows off a lot of what autumn weather is like in the UK. So we're starting to get some light coming through. We're just in golden hour at the minute, and there's about an hour till sunset. We're getting some sun lighting up the hill in the background, and I've set up a composition with this rock that I'm standing on as some foreground interest. And then we've got a path that snakes through this dying heather and leads us up to the hill. Let me show you. So, got the rock just here, that's my foreground interest, path snaking through, then up to these boulders here, and Higgator the hill in the background. Now obviously that's slightly offset from my actual picture because my camera's down here, but you get the gist. So I am going to start firing off shots before I lose this gorgeous light. The golden hour light really emphasises the colour in those heathers and ferns, and it has lit them up beautifully and showed them in the context of their environment in the Peak District. But by the time the sun is that low in the sky, you really get some shadows being cast, such as those that you can see here on the foreground rock. But as with everything in photography, it is a compromise. You can get most of what you want some of the time, but rarely everything you want. Blimey, that was quick. The light went in a matter of minutes, but I think I've got a shot in the bag. Now, one thing I would say about this is a good tip when you're wanting to get a carpet of something like this dying heather is to angle your camera down slightly. So you see here, the camera isn't pointed straight towards the hill, it's pointed down slightly. So the hill comes into the top of the frame, but more of this carpet of heather fills the frame. And the effect that has is to make the foreground feel bigger in the picture, and it compresses the background into something smaller. So I'm going to go off and try and find one last shot of the setting sun to show us these beautiful autumn colours. On the way back down, I did get a couple of decent shots and I'll show those to you now. And I think today has been really interesting because we've had every type of weather apart from the weather, which is most closely associated with autumn, and that's fog. But when I got up here and saw the conditions, it would have been crazy of me not to switch things and move to trying to capture these beautiful autumn colours. But it has meant that today's video has been a lot more on the fly, off the cuff, than I usually do. Normally I put a lot of thought into videos before I go out to film them. So it'd be interesting to see what your thoughts are on that. And if photographing landscapes in the Peak District is something that interests you, you might like to check out this video here for another walk on the wild side. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.